Absolutely, genocide.
Modern day genocide.
It's ecological breakdown.
Yeah.
And what happens when we can't grow food?
Yeah.
What happens then?
You're
so
right,
they
man.
Decided.
You're right, man.
They invented a climate change, which is just a word.
Yes.
A couple of words.
Couple of words. Yeah.
They're saying, oh, let's concentrate on climate change instead of the ones that are actually
committing the crime.
Committing the crime.
Crimes. Yeah.
Very clever by them, and they have so much money to invest in lobbying governments,
and you know what you say as well, ma'am. It's the lobbying, you know, the lobbyists when they come and they're lobbying these people here, the corruption, you know. And Martin Scorsese says a brilliant thing. He made the movie Goodfellas. He says this. He goes, money corrupts the corrupted.
Exactly. But you can't eat money.
Exactly.
Yeah. Look what's happening in Spain, in Italy.
Yeah,
they grow food. We get food from Africa is burning. Where are all these people going to go?
Yeah.
They're not going to burn to death.
Yeah,
they're going to come this way. And
mass
what happens about they're always saying immigration, stopping the boats. They're not going to ask whether they're going to come here or not.
Yeah, exactly.
They're human beings. We are all human beings. We care for every single human being.
Of course.
Or every single living thing.
Yeah.
Because we are all connected. We are nature.
We are nature. I say this, you know, this is something that I, myself personally, I always say myself, I love to be one with nature. I feel if I'm not connected with it, I'm not connected to anything. And
where,
that's how I feel.
What's that for?
Excuse me?
I mean, who are you?
Oh, well, it's a little channel.
Yeah.
I mean, if you don't mind.
No,
well,
not at all.
We had to come and see it because, as I say, because it's about the oil
and
excellent LVs. And I'm very passionate about things like that, especially now
absolutely.
Seeing the oil spills across and like, those who are responsible, the BPs, the Shells. And to think it's the way how they just nonchalantly just don't mean nothing to them, like, oh well.
Exactly, they're making so much profit on the back of the poorest.
Like you said, man, you can't eat money. You can't eat money.
And how are we going to feed all these people? I mean, people are dying already.
You're right.
They're
right.
Already dying,
yes, they
in
are.
Africa, and did you see was it in Congo?
Congo, yes.
My heart, when you see those mothers pulling their kids, dead kids from mud,
it's horrible.
How can you sit at home and not do anything?
You have to be, I mean, like you said, these people in these places and the authoritarian positions, they're cold. They just have no heart, they have no empathy.
Do you know that one of my friends, he's quite prominent in the movement, in the campaign. He said, I've met these people in 2019 when he was in a core founder of Extinction Rebellion. So when they agreed, when the government agreed, we're going to, you know, it's a climate emergency. He met all these people. He said, in these words, they are psychopaths. They don't care about anyone else. Because the brown people don't matter. And they don't matter. And poor people, they don't matter. Because we'll try to survive, but they don't know. Rich people's not going to survive.
Exactly. Well, I mean, where do they think they're going to go?
There is no planet B.
You know, Bob Marley, God rest his soul, says this, the rain does not fall on one man's house alone. So what are they going to do?
What happened with their activism? My husband is, I mean, we are now in the late 50s, early 60s.
Yeah.
So he says, when I was 15, 16, I was on the streets.
Yep, so was I.